Addressing the media this afternoon at the National Unity Platform Party offices in Kamocha, the party leadership revealed that they will take part in the Hoima City LC5 by-election, fronting Moses Aguda as the flag bearer.
People power! 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 People power!
Aguda has been the party mobilizer in Hoima City, but will now participate in the heated polls, tussling with a couple of candidates from the ruling NRM party and other opposition political parties.
It is a national election. This is the time, as NUP are going to write history, to bring an LOC 5 from Western Uganda for the first time. We have won those positions, but they have been rigging us.
The Hoima City LC 5 by-election is due to take place on the 14th of September 2023. Meanwhile, the party has also condemned the act of the public fundraising for MP Muhammad Segirinya's medical expenses on social media, saying this is wrong. They want Parliament to meet these medical costs since Segirinya is an honourable member of Parliament.
I understand that that process is being worked on for him to get the help that he deserves as a member of Parliament. He is entitled to that help, okay, because he is a member of Parliament, he is a part of the institution.
The National Unity Platform further reacted to a number of things going on in the country. Among them is the ongoing bickering in the Forum for the Democratic Change Party, human rights violations, among others.
We came in as People Power because we are representative of the people of Uganda, regardless of how powerful a political party is in the opposition. If you leave the side of the people, you will fade away into oblivion. So, I want to encourage all of you comrades that are struggling for change, do not give up.
I want to remind you that we still have many people in prisons. I thank those of you who have been calling for the release of Olivia Lutaya, Machete and others who are in detention in different prisons across the country. We still have over 100 people, our comrades, who are in detention. I thought I should talk about them. I should also remind you that up to now we have about over 20 people whose whereabouts are not known.
Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.